Today I'm in New Jersey to tour this modern Scandinavian A-frame cabin with you guys. Really excited for you to see this. This place is actually really massive. It's 3 floors total, as the first fully developed basement I've seen in an A-frame cabin. Also the loft space up top is also quite spacious. A lot of other A-frames I've toured, it's kind of like one little bedroom crammed up there. Definitely not the case in this place. Also a friendly reminder now, I have an A-frame cabin playlist actually here on YouTube. I've shot so many A-frame cabins. I love A-frames. I know you guys love A-frames. So be sure to check out my new playlist linked out down in the video description. Also down there as well is a link to book this place on Airbnb and also on their website directly as well, so you can save some money on fees. But really excited for you guys to see this modern Scandinavian A-frame cabin. It has so much to offer. So let's hop right into the tour. Welcome to this beautiful modern Scandinavian A-frame cabin. You'll notice pretty quickly there's kind of 3 rows of windows, and it gets smaller as you go more up towards the ceiling, but really just shows how massive this place is. Again, it has a ton of square footage. The loft area is really spacious, the basement. We're gonna tour everything, but you can also see these windows as well when the sun reflects off them. It's quite a sight to be seen. There's really no neighbors around. You have a lot of land out here. We'll now walk along the side of the house and head into the backyard. Now, there's a lot to cover here amenity-wise, but I actually want to focus first on this path that takes you further into the woods. And this is like a 60-second walk, and this will take you to your own private beachfront area. You got this pretty sweet view right here and a fire pit, and this is the Maurice River. It's a 60-second walk. We'll now head back to the cabin to explore more of the backyard. There is so much to see here. We'll start with this other fire pit. So you actually have 2 fire pits available to you at this Airbnb property. And of course, my favorite amenity was obviously the hot tub. I took this footage right here in the morning, actually. So I loved how the morning light and the steam off the hot tub made these really magical shots. You can actually then go on top of your deck right here. You have this really nice and inviting hammock. So you have a morning coffee or tea or read a book in the afternoon. You then also have some foldable chairs. You can take that down to the beach if you want, or right next to the fire pit. But I really just couldn't get over this hot tub. It looks especially magical at nighttime when you have all these amazing string lights all lit up and the sun is setting in the backyard. And there's a ton of string lights here, probably like 2, 3, maybe even 4 strands of these things. They're all over the place. Really lights up this space, but absolutely love the backyard. Let's now head on inside. Welcome to the interior of your modern A-frame cabin. Very open floor plan. You can see all the way to the backyard as soon as you enter. And of course, it wouldn't be an A-frame without those really tall and high vaulted ceilings. Definitely has that Scandinavian design element with the wood paneling. You have this pretty sweet sitting area though. As soon as you walk in, the biggest feature is definitely this really massive couch. You can probably fit at least 3 or 4 people just on that couch alone. So definitely a nice hangout space. You have some extra blankets, another chair in the corner. There's also a movie screen projector. They have a remote where you can just hit this button and it comes down just like this. So definitely a pretty cool feature, great for entertaining or for families or groups. We'll now begin to venture into the kitchen. You have this one countertop which runs all the way from front to back of this whole floor. We have some books and decorations and games in this one part. And then if we come over here towards this window, you have some welcome gears. You have like the welcome guide and some local information. You can read about what past guests have said. And we'll now kind of go further and deeper into the kitchen. And of course you have your kitchen table right here. It's quite spacious. You can probably fit like 5 or 6 people around just the kitchen table alone. I really just couldn't get over this countertop. It's the longest countertop I've ever seen in my life. It just keeps going and going and going. The kitchen is very modern though, and all stainless steel appliances from the fridge to the stovetop and the oven. And over here, there's a few goodies that if you want to point out that the host left for you. You have all of your coffee making supplies and actually their own coffee that they've sourced themselves called Rival Coffee, some tea as well. And kind of have a really cool retro looking speaker. You have all of your typical kind of vinegars and oils and salt and pepper, all that if you want to cook up a storm. And this is kind of your cocktail making section. So you have all this in addition to some recipes and some fire starting equipment. Next, there are two doors behind the kitchen table. We're gonna go first venture into the door on the left, and this is the first floor bedroom. This is where I slept. Again, very modern and Scandinavian with all the wood paneling and basically every square inch of this place. But I really love this setup though, especially kind of this really cool art piece that's right behind the bed that's not in any of the other bedrooms. And then kind of have a nice closet and storage space right here. You can put all your luggage and hang stuff up and some extra towels up there. And this is directly connected out towards the backyard deck and the hammock and the hot tub. Right next to that bedroom is bathroom number one of two inside this home. I really love the tiling and the white and the modern finishing throughout this bathroom, but by far my favorite part is this bathtub. Very cement and again, Scandinavian style. Definitely something I think I would have my own home someday. I'm really a huge fan of this type of interior design. That will do it for the main floor at the A-frame though. Next, we're heading to the basement. And again, I haven't really recently stayed in an A-frame or any Airbnb that really, you know, utilizes any basement to its full potential. This cabin definitely does. It makes great use of this space. This is kind of the entryway, I guess you could say, into the main basement area. So I love, again, kind of that flooring. Kind of reminds me of that artwork we saw behind the bed in the bedroom that I stayed in. But now we're gonna walk past this wooden panel door and venture into the main basement area. So the basement is comprised of two main parts. You have first kind of this entertainment space, has that red couch, and then directly across the way, you have this smart TV, has all the latest Netflix and HBO and all that good stuff. If you go further into the basement, you have four beds over in this corner. It's perfect for the kids, I think. And each bed kind of has its own like capsule, its own space. You can pull back a curtain for privacy. Definitely remind me a lot though of Scandinavia. I've been to Norway and Finland myself and reminded me a lot of the hotels I stayed in over there. We'll now head back up top though to go to the top floor of the loft area. You're first welcomed by this desk space. You can get some work done there if you want. And kind of down the hallway more, you do have your second bathroom. Bathroom two of two is right here. Very, very similar design to the bathroom we saw downstairs with all the tiling and kind of the sink and the mirror. But the main difference is that instead of a bathtub, you have this really beautiful looking shower. Also again, kind of that concrete Scandinavian style, but again, I really just love any kind of type of modern interior design these days, so he definitely knocked it out of the park. Well, now heading to the final room we have yet to cover in this A-frame cabin, and that would be the loft bedroom you see right here. Lofts are typically my favorite room out of any A-frame cabin because I just personally love how the A, or the top of the A with these two different angles, kind of intersect right here, and the ceiling is just really cool to wake up to every morning, kind of the first thing you see when you open your eyes, especially with the added Scandinavian design element. And also, if you walk straight out from your bed, then have your own private deck right here with two chairs and a little table. And this space overlooks back into your backyard, so you can look out over into the hammock and the hot tub with the river there in the background. I hope you enjoyed touring this modern A-frame cabin with me. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I know the majority of you watching this right now are not currently subscribed to the channel, so please do me a favor and hit that subscribe button. Also, a friendly reminder to check out my A-frame cabin playlist, link that down below in the video description. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next episode.